Hey everybody, welcome to my PDFelement for iOS review. In this video, I'm going to review the powerful PDF editor and viewer, PDFelement, and show you some of its convenient tools and capabilities to take your mobile PDF viewing and editing to the next level, so stay tuned. When the great people at Wondershare reached out and asked for a review, I was so happy to say yes so I could share this powerful mobile tool with my audience. When researching all the capabilities beyond what I would normally use for this video, I found out PDFelement is available on more than just iOS. You can get it on Android, and they even make desktop versions for macOS and Windows. I'll leave links for all four versions in the description below in case you'd like to check those out. PDFelement for iOS is optimized for both iPhone and iPad and allows you to do pretty much everything you'd ever want to do with a PDF directly from your iPhone. You can edit PDF text like a pro on your mobile device. You can change the font, color, and size, and you can even add text. One of the most useful features I've found with PDFelement is the ability to convert a PDF to another file type, such as a pages or a Word file. It's really easy too. Locate the file in PDFelement and press the dots to the right to bring up the additional file options. Then press Convert and choose your file type. Then press Start. And after it converts, you can press Open, and then you can send it where you want to work on it. Like in this example where I converted the user guide to a Word document, and then sent it to my MacBook Pro to work on it further. And as you can see, after opening it, it's not just a graphic that opens in Word, you can actually edit and manipulate it in Word. Very cool. PDFelement will also let you upload or connect to most of the popular cloud drive services like Dropbox, Box.net, Microsoft OneDrive, Google Drive, and of course iCloud. You can also share any PDFs using the iOS share sheet to either airdrop to another device or share it with another app on your iPhone or iPad. They even built in a really cool Wi-Fi sharing option that lets you transfer files from any computer using the same Wi-Fi through a web browser, which is great for interacting with a Windows friend. Another handy feature of PDFelement is that it will let you mark up any PDF so you can handwrite notes and even draw a picture on it. And it's really flexible too. PDFelement even has an option that lets you rearrange the PDF pages and even rotate or extract a page. The only thing I couldn't find was an easy way to add a page, but you can accomplish adding a page by using the merge function. From the PDF file viewer, choose the tool in the upper right hand corner, select more than one PDF, and the merge feature will become available along the bottom. PDFelement can also do all the things the built-in PDF editing tools can do as well, such as sign a document or fill out a form. If you'd like to check out PDFelement for yourself, it's currently a free download on the iOS App Store. I'll leave a link in the description below. And right now, you can unlock all the app's features for free by simply creating a Wondershare ID. Even if you don't think you'll use the app today, I'd still recommend getting it and creating that ID now, so you have it for free in case you need it in the future. I found it really handy for manipulating PDFs on the go, and it's been one of the best ways to convert PDFs to Word for free that I've come across. PDFelement for iOS really is a great app to read, edit, markup, and convert PDFs on the go. What do you think of PDFelement? Share your experience in the description below. And if you enjoyed this video or found it helpful, feel free to give it a thumbs up. And while you're down there, don't forget to ring that bell and subscribe to the channel for more tech videos, including tech how-tos, every week. As always, thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.